Belief in Allah and the messengers, the angels and the final day and the holy scriptures. To believe in destiny, that good and bad both come from him, and the resurrection. There is no God but Allah, the angels and the final day and the holy scriptures. To believe in destiny, that good and bad both come from him, and the resurrection. There is no God but Allah.
Inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruh, wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Dear viewers, brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And welcome to episode number 21 from the series Tawhid First. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we define Tawhid to be Ifradullah fi dhatihi wa af'alihi wa asma'ihi wa sifatihi wa huquqih. That you single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the meaning of the word singling out, you must believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no one can be like him. No one can be similar to him. No one can be a rival to him. Attributing unity to Allah, ifradullah, singling out Allah in his divine essence. His essence is divine. Our essence is not divine. His essence is free of needs. Our essence are needy. His essence is not part of his creation in any form or shape. You must believe that. You must also single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be the creator. Meaning, you cannot believe that Mother Nature created. You cannot believe that there is any other created force, created Allah, created anything of Allah's creation, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Impossible. لو كان فيهما آلهة إلا الله لفسدتا. If there are other creations besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِذَا لَذَهَبَ كُلُّ إِلَهٍ بِمَا خَلَقٍ. Every creator will dominate his creations, and this will lead certainly to a conflict. وَلَعَلَى بَعْضُهُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ. Brothers and sisters in Islam, you must single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also to be the sovereign, the owner. You must single him out to be the knower of the unseen. You must single him out to be the one who benefit, النافع, the one who can decree harm upon you because you earn it, the one who guides, and the one who can let you go into misguidance because you decided to go this way, subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cannot believe that there is any other force out there that does this, including fortune cookies, including soothsayers, including imams, including sheikhs, human beings, including people who are buried. If you believe that there is any other force out there that can benefit you or harm you without the permission of Allah, you have failed to single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his lordship. You must believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the disposer of the affairs of his creations. You must also believe in the perfect attributes and the beautiful names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you must affirm it. You must believe in it without liking it to the humans and with no hope that you can visualize it or find out how it works, how it looks like. But we believe it works in a certain way. And only knows, the only one who knows this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as a result of this, you single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with your actions, with His rights upon you. We presented Tawheed to you, and then we got into presenting the deviated Tawheed, the people who gone astray in the area of attributing unity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala once it comes to His divine essence, names and attributes, and lordship, and His worship. And we embarked and we spent two episodes. We spoke about Sufism, we spoke about Al-Jahmiyyah, Al-Mu'tazila, and we briefly spoke about Al-Qadariyyah, those who deny Al-Qadr. Dear viewers, I would like you to understand, in brief, your belief in Al-Qadr, and why those people, Al-Qadariyyah, are in trouble, those who deny the Qadr. Al-Qadr comprises four pillars. Arkan al-Qadr, al-ilm, al-kitaba, al-mashi'ah, al-khalq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew everything that happened in the past, happens now, will happen in the future with no end. Al-ilm. إن الله عالم غيب السماوات والأرض. Allah is the knower of the unseen in the heavens and the earth. العلم. Now comes in writing. Writing. Allah wrote that in اللوح المحفوظ, the preserved tablet. Now the writing happens four times, or happened four times. Pay attention here. Happened four times. Al-Taqdeer al-Azali, 50,000 years before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote who you are, your birthday, who are your parents, your place of birth, how long you will live, how you will die, the place of your death, written in that preserved tablet. When? إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَتَبَ مَقَادِيرَ الْخَلَائِقِ بِخَمْسِينَ أَلْفَ سَنَةِ قَبْلَ أَنْ يَخْلُقَ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. 50,000 years before He created the heavens and the earth. So الكتابة في الأزل. طيب, let me ask you, does it mean that this cannot change? That is why it comes in the will. Allah must will it. المشيئة, الإرادة. So the writing can be edited. Imagine a woman who is barren, never had babies, never had children, and she really wanted to have children so bad. Okay? And subhanallah, she makes dua. Oh Allah, give me children. Even so, in the preserved tablet, Al-Lawh Al-Mahfuz, she is written not to have children. If Allah accepts her dua, this can be edited. This can change. This can change. The second writing happens lifespan. Your writing again happens. التقدير العمري, the lifespan. What do you mean by that? Here it is. Hadith Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, في صحيح الإمام مسلم, that إن الله يجمع خلق إن خلق أحدكم يجمع في بطن أمه 40 يوما نطفة. Basically, the overall meaning of the hadith, after 120 days, an angel comes and writes four things: how long you will live, rich or happy, شقي أم سعيد, your provision. An amal, your deed, what you will do. Let's imagine that a woman, you know, who's about to get pregnant before the 120 days. Allah decreed that she has a disbelieving baby in her womb, in the preserved tablet. But this righteous woman raises her hand, Ya Rab, bestow upon me a righteous baby, Ya Rab. Even so, it's written. So when the angel writes the lifespan qadr, that can change by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is why the third pillar is the will, the irada, the mashia. Not because it's written, it's over. The means is a dua. You can make dua. طيب, there is an annual writing, the night of Laylatul Qadr. Huh? Let's say that in Ramadan, you're supposed to die a month after Ramadan. And you did i'tikaf the last 10 nights of the month, and you happen to coincide with Laylatul Qadr, and you made this dua, Ya Rab, give me a long life with Iman, Ya Rab, with faith. That is the restriction when you ask for a long life. You're written to die a month after Ramadan. You see, in Laylatul Qadr, Allah again decrees what will happen until the next Laylatul Qadr. Allah could edit that because of your dua. Every day, likewise, this is the fourth writing. Every day, there is the annual, the lifespan, I'm sorry, the eternal in the preserved tablet, the lifespan, the annual, the night of Laylatul Qadr, and there is the daily. So this could be changed by the dua. That is why the Prophet ﷺ says, الدُعاءُ وَالْقَدَرْ يَتَعَالَجَانِ. Dua and qadr, they fight one another. If the dua is strong and accepted by Allah, Allah could decree better things for you. Ishahid, or the important things, brothers and sisters in Islam, comes in the creation, which is the fourth pillar of al-qadr, the creation of the actions, the people, the creation of people and their actions. وَاللَّهُ خَلَقَكُمْ وَمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. So Allah created us to implement this. Now al-qadariya denied all of this. They denied the knowledge, they denied the writing, they denied the will, they rejected all of this. That is why they went astray in the area of Tawheed. That is why they deviated from Tawheed. We must believe in al-qadr, khayrihi wa sharrihi, and we must stay away from rejecting al-qadr. Ta'ala Allah, that he doesn't know. Ta'ala Allah, Allah is above that. Subhana wa ta'ala, that he doesn't know. Subhana wa ta'ala, that he did not write. Subhana wa ta'ala, he doesn't have a will. Again, this has to do with the names and the attributes of Allah. This is why they went astray. Brothers and sisters in Islam, let's take a short break and come back and talk about some more deviation in Tawheed committed by people who say La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. We'll see you in a little bit. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
This belief in Allah and the messengers, the angels and the final day and the holy scripture.
Only if we knew Allah, we would truly worship Him.
How can you worship someone you don't even know?
We would love Him, fear Him, and have hope in His mercy.
Wallahi, wallahi, wallahi. And I challenge anyone in the earth, anyone in the world, to tell me one time in their life that they took the means and they put their trust in Allah and Allah let them down.
Only if you knew with Majid Mahmood in Ramadan, only on Huda TV.
وسلامتي والإسلام اللهم أهلا وعليك.
This belief in Allah and the messengers, the angels and the final day and the holy scripture.
Dear viewers, brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back to Tawheed First. We're talking about people who went off the path of Tawheed. And again, the intention here is not to harm anybody, is not to label anybody. The intention is to show you where they deviated. Education, simply. Education. and also to try to give them da'wah. In this segment of the episode, I would like to share with you how al-Rawafid, al-Shia al-Ithna Ashriya, the Imami Shia, deviated in the area of Tawheed. Their focus is in the area of al-Rububiyya and al-Uluhiyya. I know this subject is very sensitive, and I know that there are a lot of calls out there that, you know, don't do this, don't talk about this, this divides Muslims. And listen, the issue has to do with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and shirk and so forth. And with this particular segment, you know what? I have provided evidence from their books. So I'm not throwing allegations. I will read to you these slides and you tell me, can we meet somewhere? Can we? You tell me. Let's begin. The Imams possess all the knowledge granted to angels and prophets and messengers. This book is called Al-Kafi. The author is Al-Kullini, page number 255. Now, how in the world do you say that? Imams are regular people. They are not divine. You cannot attribute divinity to anybody. Any essence beside Allah is not divine. The only essence which is divine, hatta our messenger, is not divine. Christians, they confined the passing on of divinity to one person, which is Isa alayhi salam, Jesus. They are passing on divinity to 12 people, 12 individuals, that they are divine. They possess the knowledge which are granted to the prophets and messengers. This is totally shirk in the lordship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tayyib, another statement. The Imams know when they will die, and they do not die except by their choice. Again, Al-Kafi, Al-Kullini, page 258. Oh, from their books. They know when they will die. مَفَاتِحُ الْغَيْبِ خَمْسِ. The five keys of the unseen are five. And then Hadith ibn Umar. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam recited the last verse in Surah Luqman. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عِنْدَهُ عِلْمُ السَّاعَةِ وَيُنَزِّلُ الْغَيْثَ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي الْأَرْحَامِ وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ مَاذَا تَكْسِبُ غَدًا وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ بِأَيِّ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ خَبِيرٌ. Oh, the knowledge of the hour, rain coming down, what is inside the womb of the mother, where you will die and how you will die, and the place when you will die and how you will die. Now they are saying that they know the unseen. You see, the knowledge of dying is unseen. When you will die is unseen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ لَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ الْغَيْبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Only Allah knows the unseen. Now, you attributing the knowledge of the unseen to the Imams. That is shirk in the lordship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. The Imams have the knowledge of whatever occurred in the past. I'm sorry, this is... And whatever will happen in the future, and nothing is concealed from them. الإمام يعرف ما حدث وما سيحدث وما فيش شيء ما بخ... أهو الكليني, their book, الكافي للكليني, the author is الكليني, page number 260. هذا شرك في الربوبية. The only one who knows what happened in the past, what will happen in the future, and what is happening now is Allah. Because this is unseen. Now, hada shirk, you're given that person divinity. The hatta Isa ibn Maryam said to his disciples, I don't know when the hour is. Oh, hada shirk, how can you say we can be together? Impossible. Impossible to be together with somebody who believes that there is a human being who knows the unseen. Because the knowledge of the unseen belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tayyib. The imams have knowledge of all the revealed books, regardless of the language in which they were revealed. Come on. No one compiled. Oh, this is a big issue right here. Big issue. The issue of the Quran. You see, if the Mu'tazila, Jahmiyyah, they said the Quran is created, those, they said what? The Quran is not complete. When Allah says, Inna nahnu nazzalna al-dhikra wa inna lahu lahafidhun. No one compiled the Quran completely except the Imams, and they encompass all of its knowledge. Al-Kullini. The Imams? La. In order for us to understand the Quran explains the Quran. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explains the Quran. The Sahaba. The Sahaba. They discredited the Sahaba. So the Imams can take on explaining the Quran. You got it? Why they attack the Sahaba? Why? Because the Sunnah explains the Quran. You need to understand. Pay attention, brothers. The Sunnah explains the Quran. You see, if you open any book of Sunnah, you end up with something before the statement of the Prophet ﷺ, something called chain of narration. Al-Bukhari says what? I haddathani. I heard that hadith from that person. Haddathani. So, haddathani. So, the chain, the sanad, the chain of narration must end with a sahabi, Abu Huraira. So you go to somebody who's Rafidi, Shi'i, from that sect. Okay, the Prophet ﷺ said, who narrated this hadith? Abu Huraira. Kafir. Disbeliever. He's not Abu Huraira. He's not after Abu Huraira. La. He's trying to reject what Abu Huraira narrated from the messenger. But if he says, I'm going to reject what the messenger said, it's an absurd, it's a big statement. So they go about it what? Indirectly. Why? Because if they remove the Sunnah explains the Quran, then the Imams right here, the Imams will then interpret the Quran their way. The person who says that the present Quran is complete is a liar. Imagine this. If you say that the Quran is perfect and complete, the Quran is kamil, takadhab, you're a liar. Because the complete Quran was compiled by Hadrat Ali, alayhi salam, and subhanallah, faslu al-khitab fi tahrif kitab rabbi al-arbab, page number 4, right here. The munafiqoon, the sahaba, talk very much out of the Quran, talk out the verses of al-wilaya and so forth. Again, I'm giving references. These are not allegations. This is from their books. When the Imam Mahdi comes back, he will bring the complete, the real, original Quran with him. Come on. This is totally out of line for me to believe that. Look at this. There is not a single truth possessed by a people saved that which originated with the Imams. And everything which did not proceed from them is false. Everything must come from the Imams. Here is the big, big piece here. Look at the last bullet. All of the earth belongs to the Imams. Allahu Akbar. لِلْأَئِمَّةِ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ مُلْكُ الْأَرْضِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the owner of the heavens and the earth. They say the Imams, they possess the earth. So اشتركوا معي. They associated the Imams with Allah. They associated لِلَّهِ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. You know that verse? It's supposed to read what? مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لِلَّهِ. Technically. يعني لله is خبر. خبر إيه؟ مقدم. And when you place the خبر before the مبتدا اختصاص بتخص. You say that no one else owns anything in the heavens and earth. They say what? The kingship, the ownership of the heavens and the earth belongs to the Imams. لا. هذا شرك. I'm sorry, I cannot believe that. طيب. Look at this. The last type here is Tawhid of al-Falasifa, and this is easy. It's very similar to Tawhid al-Jahmiyyah wal-Mu'tazila. They simply basically proven that Allah exists. Meanwhile, negated, rejected all his names and attributes. And this is the Tawhid of al-Falasifa, ulama al-Kalam. Ibn Sina, one of the, يعني, subhanAllah, a lot of people praise him, but he's the one who said stuff like that. يعني هم يثبتون الذات من غير أسماء وصفات. As if you're affirming, you're believing in an idol. والعياذ بالله. SubhanAllah. والعياذ بالله. Dear viewers, with this, بفضل الله تعالى, we conclude addressing the issue of deviations from Tawheed committed by a lot of people who say La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. Again, I'm stressing, I'm not here to ridicule, critique. I'm just explaining the aqidah of our righteous predecessors. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I was successful in doing so. And if I have يعني, made a mistake, my intention is to seek the conveying of that aqidah in the perfect way possible. Sometimes the language could lead me to say something that is not in context. I ask Allah to forgive me, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make me and all of you dear viewers a follower of that aqidah, the aqidah of our righteous predecessor, because this is the only authentic, correct, pure aqidah exist in the face of this earth. And this is what is meant by hadith al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the 73 sects. 72 of them are in hell. Only one is in Jannah. This one is the one which possesses the proper tawheed, the proper tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Till the next episode of Tawheed First, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
This belief in Allah and the messengers, the angels and the final day and the holy scriptures, to believe in destiny that good and bad both come from him, and the resurrection, there is no God but Allah, the angels and the final day and the holy scriptures, to believe in destiny that good and bad both come from him, and the resurrection, there is no God but belief in Allah and the messengers, the angels and the final day and the holy scriptures, to believe in destiny that good and bad both come from him, and the resurrection.